On-call football with how many foreign born players every African Cup of Nations has. Now, just before we start this video, these are seven UEFA affiliates that are part of the association, but I will not consider them to be part of the European League due to the fact that, well, geographically they're outside of Europe and very rarely do players often go to these places in search of high quality football. So, starting off with the Ivory Coast, just 9 homegrown players are in the squad, and only 8 of them are based outside of Europe, proving, well, frankly, I mean, the Ivorian League only has about 2 or 3 homegrown players. Well, no, 2 players playing domestically in this national team, and this will become a regular theme, as Equatorial Guinea only have 8 players born in their country from their squad, as of course they are a country of just less than 2 million people. Only 3 of them are homegrown, only 4 of them are based outside of Europe. Then we get on to Nigeria, who have taken 25 players. A huge 18 of them were born in Nigeria, but just 7 of them graduated from a Nigerian football academy, and just 6 of them play their football outside of Europe, proving again how important it is for the top African teams to have European based players. Then we go on to Guinea-Bissau, where, I, as strange as it looks, only 1 of their players is homegrown, due to the fact that the vast majority of them all head for the football academies in Portugal when they hit their teenagers, due to, of course, Guinea-Bissau's legacy as a Portuguese colony. So many young players take advantage of that opportunity. Then we move on to Egypt, where we have a huge change of criteria, where every single one of their players is born in Egypt. And 25 of them were actually born, came through the Egyptian Academy. I think, of course, Mo Salah was one of only 2 players in this squad, along with Mohamed Al-Stefa. I can't remember his name, but they're the only ones that came through a European Academy. And just 4 of their players play in Europe, including Mo Salah, Mustafa, and a couple of others, proving that Egypt has an incredibly strong academy system, and its domestic league is actually quite competitive, considering I think at least 20 of those non-European based players play at home in Egypt. Then we move on to Ghana, where it's back to the usual stuff, where most of the players, as they get older, will move on from Ghana, as of course the domestic league in Ghana is pretty weak, like so many of the sub-Saharan leagues out there. Of course, the 2 Ayew brothers, as much flack as they get, actually came through the come from Europe, and of course many others like Tarek Lamptey and Naki Williams and Semenyo were born and raised in Europe and came through a European academy. So Ghana has a decent diaspora to call from, but of course they do have a habit of losing the very best talents that descended from their nations to, of course, the big European teams, just like Nigeria. Then moving on to Cape Verde, where a country of just over 600,000 people, but astonishingly, 11 of their players were actually born in the country, but only 5 of them came through the Cape Verde Academy. And in order to, of course, be able to supplement the numbers, only 8 of these players play outside of Europe, mostly in the Middle East. So, as much as Cape Verde and, of course, Equatorial Guinea success does look amazing on paper, they are heavily relying on their diaspora. Then we get on to Mozambique, where, remarkably, they actually do rely very heavily on their homegrown system, 16 of them being homegrown and 14 of their 23 players being based outside of Europe, with at least 11 of those players playing at home in Mozambique, proving that their success against Ghana and Egypt with their 2-2 draws is a well-merited result. Grinding out results, proving there is hope for Mozambique football. Then we get on to the defending champion, Senegal. 15 players were born in the country, but only 9 of them came through the academy, and only 6 of them play their football outside of Europe. Of course, the only home-based players, of course, their goalkeepers, as is a usual theme throughout this video, due to, of course, African goalkeepers being frowned upon quite heavily. And now, of course, speaking of Cameroon, who do, of course, have a goalkeeper playing for Man United in the Premier League, but is getting a lot of flack. It's Cameroon. 50 of their players were born in Cameroon, but only 6 of them came through a Cameroonian academy, and 12 of them play outside of Europe. Then we get on to Guinea, where 13 of their players were born in the country, 8 of them came through their academy, but only 4 of them play outside of Europe, proving Guinea, just like so many, rely on their diaspora to do the work for them. Then we get on to Gambia, who, despite being a tiny nation of 3 million people, are able to call upon 21 of their players born in the country. And of course, they almost did put off a shock result against Cameroon. 13 of them came through the academy. But of course, in order to maximise their talent, of course, only 8 of them play outside of Europe, with the other 19 being in Europe. Then we get on to Algeria, where of course, they have a huge surplus of diaspora in France, meaning that they only have to pick 12 players born in Algeria, and 11 of them came through the Algerian academy system, and 10 of them play outside of Europe. One, of course, Riyad Mahrez and Slimani being the 2 notable names, with Mahrez in Saudi Arabia, and of course, Slimani playing for Corinthians in Brazil. A very strange choice to be playing football, but hey. Then we've got Burkina Faso, who, despite being a small nation, have 17 of their 27 players playing their football that were born in the country, and came, 30 of them came through the academy system, but only 7 of them are based outside of Europe. Then we get Mauritania, who, of course, despite having to call up a lot of their European-based diaspora for this tournament, 16 of them do play their football outside of Europe, mostly in the Middle East and, of course, African leagues. But there are a few Mauritanian domestic players in there as well. Then we get on to Angola, one of the underdogs, 27 players. 20 of them were born in the country, but only 14 of them went through the academy system. But having said that, though, they've done very well to top their group, because, of course, 15 of those players play there football outside of Europe. Then we get on to Tunisia, who have been struggling so much in this tournament. 17 players born in their country, 18 of them came through the academy, due to, of course, a couple of those players having their parents relocate back to Tunisia after being born in France. And then 14 of those players, of course, most of them playing in the Tunisian domestic league, play their football there. Then we have Mali, a smallish nation, but, you know, whilst they do have a lot of players born in the squad in their own nation, of course, only 5 of them play outside of Europe, proving how pivotal playing in the big European leagues is for these sub-Saharan African players. But then we get on to South Africa, where there's a huge plot twist, where every single player is actually born in the country. Just one of them was developed outside of the country. I keep forgetting the player's name. And only 2 of those players are playing football outside of Europe, with, of course, the vast majority of their squad playing back home in South Africa. It has to be said, South Africa doesn't really export top players anymore. Of course, I think Percy Tau now plays his football in Egypt, so Yeah, that's how much South Africa has slipped off the footballing map. Then we get on to the tournament favourites, Morocco, a huge diaspora with only 9 players in the squad born in the country, only 7 of them coming through the academy, only 7 of them playing their football outside of Europe. Of course, most notably, a lot of them playing in Saudi Arabia. Then we get on to DR Congo. I apologise for the humorous image, but I had to put it there. 7 players, despite being a huge 100 million plus population nation, just 7 of their players were actually born in the country. Only 4 of them came through the academy system, proving that despite being a huge, massive country, DR Congo does rely heavily on their European diaspora to help them out in these tournaments. Then we get on to Tanzania, who have got actually rely very heavily on their players born inside the country, and most of their players don't even play in Europe, proving that they are very much punching above their weight. Then we got Zambia, where an impressive 26 of their players were actually born in the country, and all but 3 of them came through the academy system. And again, most of them playing outside of Europe, with a lot of them being going to the big African leagues. And then we've got Namibia, the last one on this list, who have only 23 players, every single one of them born in the country. Only one of them, I think, was his name, Ryan Nyambi, coming, all came through. But Ryan Nyambi, of course, immigrated to Britain when he was a young lad, went through the Blackburn Rovers academy system, and only 3 of their players, along with Ryan Nyambi, who now plays for Derby County, and 2 other players who play for a club in Kosovo, play their football in Europe. And it really does illustrate what a massive triumph Namibia's 1-0 win over Tunisia really was. So thank you for watching this rather interesting video.